All right, now we will see how to visualize analog IOs in our HMI. So the steps are quite similar, but we have to check some objects. So if you see on the right side, I hope you can see that, otherwise I will maybe move the camera. Wait a second. Let's put it here maybe. Yeah. Now on the bottom right, you can see some symbols in the HMI. If you see, this is a main HMI. And here we have used the buttons and ellipse. Now if you go down, you will see some symbols. So I would like to use some horizontal gauge. Okay, so I will take this one, put it here. So this is my horizontal gauge. I want to use it for analog IOs. Okay, so let's use this for analog input 1, the channel 1 in our PLC. So I would like to put some text here. PLC analog IOs, and this represent, maybe put it down, copy paste again, and let's call it IN1. This is my first channel. Okay, so what to do now? If you select this one, you will see some properties. This is symbol instance, this is a behavior, it's stack selectable. So the main thing we need to do is check the settings. Now this is the scaling. For example, now you see from 0 to 100. Okay, so we can say this is showing in percentage. If you want to show it as a voltage, I can change this to 0 to 10 volts because that's what I want to see. So it totally depends upon you what you want to see here. If 0 to 10 volt represent just the voltage for you, you can use 0 to 10 here. If you want to see it as a percentage, you can do 0 to 100. If you have a speed of motor, for example, you are giving this value to a VFD. Okay, so your VFD has a frequency from 0 to 50 Hertz or 0 to 60 Hertz. So you can define what scale you want to use in your screen. So let's take, in this example, I'll take 10. So this is just the voltage. So I will get 0 to 10 volt representation. Okay. Now the tick interval is 10, so that the numbers which you see on the scale, I will change this to 1, so I can see from 0 to 10, because at every one step I see an interval. So you can also change it to 0.1 or 0.5. I think this is the minimum, so you can't go below 0. So this is 0. Oh, this is 1. Now what you have to do, another thing is, if you remember in our analog, we have a range, 0 to 30,000. So I'll take a highest range in the needle dynamic path. Okay, let me just cross check. Yeah, here you will change to 30,000. So the needle knows that my 0 is 0 and 30,000 is 10. So this is automatically scaled in the HMI. All right, so we'll see the results. And then you go to parameters, go to variable and define which variable you want to see. I go to, okay, for the variable, you can go to AXE and analog 01. One way is to read directly from the PLC. But if you remember the last steps, we have to go here again. And I prefer to use HMI tags. So right click here, add HMI tag, analog 01, and add HMI tag, output 01. So I will read analog 01. So I go back to my parameters and HMI web server. Now I have analog 01. Okay, so that's it. This is now going to read my analog input 01. Okay, let's try that. Let's download it and have a look. So write and start project. I can make this a little bit bigger. So the project is being written. It's already written. I'll open the screen. So you can see some values coming here. And I go to launch HMI simulator. Admin, S37, my password. Okay, so now you see here, This is the value 19301, and that's my range. Currently it's showing 6.44 volts, which you can also see here, but that's my analog output, which is also actually equivalent to analog input because we have seen in the last examples. So now if I move it, you can see the value is also moving in my HMI, and this is reduced, and you can also see the voltage 2.74 something. So that's how you can monitor analog input on your HMI screen. Quite easy, just scale it to your digital range and put the scale 0 to 10, whatever you want. Now let's see how we can do it for analog output, but before that I want to show you how to display this voltage, the value which is coming here, somewhere here or in the bottom. Okay, there are also ways to do that. So what I was telling you, like the value which you see here, 7.51 voltage, I want to see it here. So how can I do that? So in this case I have to change a little bit of programming because we have to scale in the PLC and display it here. Okay, so what I can do is, there are many ways to do that, but I will show you the easiest one. I hope that's the easiest one. So now I will change some program. I don't want to move analog input directly to the output, so I will delete this and delete this. So that's my analog input. Now I go to variables. Now I know that I need to display the value in real, okay, but this value is coming in the PLC as double integer, because if you see analog 01 is double integer. Okay, I need to change that. So I will take a variable. Okay, now I need a variable which is not external, so let's group these variables. So I will rename that. I hope I can. Yep, I will write it external IOs, and here I will create a new group and I will call it local. So I take a variable, let's say temp 01, and let's name it data type real, and that's a local. Okay, so what I do is I go back to my code and I will search. Let's bring this guy down. Or maybe we don't need it at the moment. So here I will search real, and I will see to real. Okay, bring it here. So this will convert this to real, and now I need to give an output which I just defined, temp 01. Okay, so I go back to my variables and I know this temp 01 is here. So this will convert this into real. Now we know that my digital range, which is coming to analog 01, is 0 to 30,000. And I want to show my floating range from 0 to 10.0. Okay, so I will simply divide this temp 01 with 300. Simple as that. Well, that's a simple scaling. So now I will take divide. And I need a simple divide arithmetic operation. So I divide my temp 01 with just write 300. You can do that. And now we need an output. So I go to my variables again and I need an external output now. So I will write analog IN 01 scaled. And this is my real, and that's external. So this will be my scaled output. Go back to my code. I will type my variable scale. So the scaled value comes in this variable. Okay. And this variable, I want to show it now in the HMI. Okay, let me align it. Analog 01. So I go back to my PLC data list. And here in the bottom, you will find the variable I defined. Analog 01 scaled. This should be in the HMI. So right click, add HMI tag. So this is coming in the HMI now. So I go back to my HMI. Now I want to show this value here, the scaled value. How to do that? It's quite easy. Just go to the HMI, remove the filter, go back to the HMI again. In the object, you will find text. Just bring it here. So this is the text, but we need a dynamic text, not or normal text like this. So we will add some dynamics to it. So a new dynamics. Now you will go to text because that's just displaying a number. So click text and then give the variable from the server analog 01 scaled. So that's the variable now. So you can see the value is also mentioned here. And now that's my text defined. I would like to, if you want, you can change the color of the text. So I would change that to like this. Okay. So this is how you get an analog scaled value. Let's try that now. Write and start project. It will take a few seconds. I will activate my camera. And we go to, first I will show you how to see it in the PLC. So it's downloaded. Now, here, divide it. Oh, sorry, sorry, it's not 300, it's 3000. It was 30,000 was the maximum limit, so it should be 3000. My mistake. Let me go back to programming. Now, right now it's showing in percentage, so I have to add an extra zero. So, download again, write and start project. Downloaded, and now you can see this is coming 7.51 volt. This is my analog input. And if I see in this browser, in this trainer, I reduce it to zero. Now it's 0 volt. Now this is somewhere near 3. So this is 3.6 volt. And if I see my simulator, this is the same value we are showing here. Admin. So that's the voltage coming. One more thing is you can reduce the number of digits which you want to see after the start. So that you can also do, but I will show you here now. First, I move the value and I can see my voltage. Now how to change that, because this is not interesting to see. So go back to your HMI page. After going offline, select this one, and there should be some dynamics. Format, how many digits after decimal? Let's say just 2 digits. That's it, that's all you need to do. So I will write it again. Write and start project. Okay, now going back to the simulator. Log in again. And now we can see the voltage just in 2 digits. So this is about how you can visualize your analog input in a scaled format on your HMI. In the next, this is video is getting long. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to give the voltage from the HMI to the voltage analog I/O device, okay, to the analog output device. So that we will see in the next video. So stay tuned.